Gonna be really awkward if someone walks in. Okay, so it's been a while since I've made a video. My name is Miro. I'm in the company of a flatmate at the moment, so if you hear any noise, it's her. That's why I'm laughing as well. I have a script for the first time, and that's why I'm gonna be looking at my screen for the whole video probably. So I have a few pickups since the last time I made a video basically. I'm gonna start off with the basics, with the more boring stuff, and then move over to the more interesting pieces. Let's start with some Uniqlo pickups. I've secretly been wanting to come into the UK just to pick up some stuff from Uniqlo. The first piece is a single sock. As you can see, it used to be in a pair, but unfortunately I lost the second one while doing my laundry. Yeah, I've been wanting to try out Uniqlo socks for a while just because I've heard they are of nice quality, and it's honestly just a pair of socks, so it's nothing too crazy. They're pretty soft and comfortable. This was, I think it's called a mushroom color. There were a few colors, and this was the only one that was in my size I liked, so I went for it. Next, I have a Uniqlo t-shirt. It's 100% Pima cotton, which I have no idea what it is. I basically needed a plain white basic t-shirt. I went with a size small and to get a tighter fit, but I think I should have gone for an extra small just because I feel like this fits more like a medium, or it might be that I'm just smaller than I think. Fabric is on the thinner side, but it's still pretty comfortable, and it has a weight to it, so it keeps its shape when you wear it, and it doesn't cling to your body. Okay, let's take a break from the Uniqlo pickups for now. Next, I have a couple of t-shirts. I don't think I've shown these before. The first one is from Amok. If you're new to the channel and you don't follow me on Instagram, which you should, at Miro with 10 underscores. Amok is a Bulgarian brand. My homies basically own it. They do clothing as well as music, so if you haven't checked them out yet, go ahead and do so. Second tee I have is a pink floor t-shirt. It's from 2001, so it isn't single stitched, but it still counts as vintage. Size medium. It has the iconic "Wish You Were Here" on the back, which Travis Scott obviously stole for his merch. It's one of my favorite vintage t-shirts I own. Okay, next I have a couple of long sleeves. Let's start off with this white one. I think I've had it for over a year actually, but a couple of months ago I put it under my sewing machine. I went across the front and the back with a stitch, so I wanted to make it slimmer but also keep the shape and the sleeves as they are. I also posted a pic of my back in it just because I can. The next one is from Uniqlo again. It is a mock neck, and I've been wanting to try out mock necks for a while, and I've honestly been missing out on them because I think they can add a great detail to your outfit, sort of elevated. Size small again. Maybe I should have gone for an extra small again, but this works as well. The only complaint I have about it is that the neck is just a bit wider than I want it to be, so when you wear it, it sort of sticks out a bit, but it's nothing too extreme. Here I have a knit, which I've had for more than a year again, but I haven't worn it before. I distressed it, removed the bone hem. Let's do accessories now. I saw some guy with a tote bag on the streets once, and I thought it looked pretty cool, so I decided to try out using a tote bag as my school bag. So I got this one from a student fair for free. It has some graphics on this one, on this side, and it's plain on the other side, and I obviously wore it with the plain side out. I used it for a month carrying my laptop and some miscellaneous stuff as well, but it's really not what I was expecting. I guess my laptop was too heavy for it, so it was always falling off my shoulder and things like that, and it was also really awkward reaching into it to get some stuff out of it. It pretty much doesn't work as I wanted to, so I ordered a tote bag from Uniqlo, which turned out to be huge, as you can see. Definitely not appropriate for school because my laptop is gonna take up only like 1/3 of it, and I can't really fill it up. I use it when I visited my friend in Leeds as my main luggage, so it was pretty nice. It has a sturdy exterior, which I like, and the straps are long enough so you can wear it over your shoulder or just hanging down. It costed like £2 and it's eco-friendly, so I thought I might as well get it. But as I said, it doesn't really work as a school bag, so I had to get something more appropriate. So I ordered this backpack from Uniqlo again. It's actually a Trayvon bag. It works as a backpack. It has some straps on the back, as you can see. It has a briefcase, so it has handles over here, so you can wear it like this. And it also had a long strap, which you can attach over here on these loops. Use it as a messenger bag, which I won't do, so I took out the strap. It has one small front pocket, two sort of side pockets, which kind of look weird, because if you open this one, it's like you're opening the bottom of the backpack. But it's meant to be used mainly as a briefcase, I guess. And it obviously has this main big compartment in which you can keep your laptop and some other stuff as well. It's honestly a bit too much space for me at the moment, because I don't put too much things in it, but it does the trick. I also was looking for some backpack, because obviously the tote bag wasn't working, and I didn't want to go for the classic backpack look, because I feel like it doesn't go well with my style. And I think this works better, but I'm still trying to find the perfect school bag. Doesn't have to be a backpack necessarily, but yeah, if you have any recommendations, you can comment or DM me on Instagram. Last accessory I have is actually on my hand. It's this Chrome Hearts spacer ring. I have some doubts that it might be fake, but I paid pretty much the price for a real one, and the seller had 100% or like 99 point something percent positive feedback, so I think it's alright and it's still pretty cool. It says "Real Fucking Punk" on the outside, and on the inside, as you can see, it has the classic chrome. It's from 2009 and it's also silver. The size is 7.5 US and it fits on my pointer finger and on my middle finger as well. I honestly prefer the pointer finger for some reason. The last accessory, unfortunately not with us anymore, is a pair of black leather gloves, which I picked up at TK Maxx for a great price, and I somehow managed to lose them while I was in London, and I'm pretty sure some lady stole them, so that's a pretty sad story. And they were honestly one of my favorite accessories I've ever had, because they can take an outfit, make it look much more interesting just by adding them on. But I managed to wear them twice for a fit pick, so I guess I got my worth out of them. We are almost finished. I have a couple of pairs of denim. I'm gonna start off with these black ones. Guess where they are from? That's right, Uniqlo. It's a pair of black selvedge denim. I just needed a pair of black skinny denim for, you know, they wear just something I can toss on. But they fit pretty baggy, like not even baggy, but I wanted them to have a skinny fit. And they were more or less on the slim side. So yeah, I got them in a size 36 length, so because I want them to stack. The waist is 30, and for some reason it's either way too big, like it isn't true to size, or it's just that I'm not a size 30, because I have way too much room in these, like the waist fits pretty big. Yeah, I got them tailored to get them to fit skinnier. And I'm still not completely happy with them, but they definitely fit better now. Yeah, that's pretty much it about these jeans. They are pretty nice, they have a little stretch in them. It's not too much. It still feels like a sturdy pair of jeans. It doesn't feel like some cheap pair sold in H&M, for example. And then the next pair I have is a vintage pair of Levi's, which I'm really happy with. I've been looking for so long for a nice light wash pair of denim, and these are pretty much perfect. They are the 510, which is the somewhat skinny model. Obviously the iconic patch on the back with the sizing. I also have to mention that these are a size 29 waist and a 34 length, so they do stack as well. They have some minor signs of wear, which honestly wish they had some more distressing and stuff, but it's okay, I'm gonna put it into them as I wear them, because these are honestly my top three, I guess, pairs of jeans that I own. They're really nice. As I said, I've been looking for a pair like these for a while, and I got them pretty cheap as well, much cheaper than the Uniqlo denim. Something I forgot to mention about the Uniqlo denim is that they are actually the first brand new pair of jeans that I've purchased in the last 4 years, which I'm honestly proud of, because it's way more sustainable to buy secondhand than to buy brand new. And I have like 20, 25, maybe even 30 pairs of jeans and pants in general, and none of them in the last 4 years have been brand new. So yeah, I'm proud of myself, even if you don't care. So we are almost finished. The last piece I have, probably the coolest one, probably my favorite one, is this wool coat from River Island that I got for free. I basically needed a winter jacket. I've honestly wanted to try out this silhouette for a while now, but I feel like now that I've refined my aesthetic and my taste, and now that I take the fit and how it looks on my body into account a lot more, I feel like it was the perfect time for me to get a coat like this, because before I used to just buy whatever, like even if it was oversized, I would just think that oversized always looks good, which is, I've come to realize, it's not the truth. Like, you have to be aware of how it looks on your body and how it looks in relation to the rest of the outfit. So this coat, it goes great with skinny jeans, with slim jeans, with pants as well. Like, I obviously don't have any wider pants, but I'm pretty sure it would go great with them as well. And also, I can wear it with sneakers, I can wear it with some boots. Yeah, it's pretty nice. I got it from River Island, as I said. Obviously wanted something better, but I was also trying out the style. So it's my first one, and the next one I get is probably gonna be more expensive, like from a higher end brand, for example, Saint Laurent. Who knows if I have the money for it. This is probably my favorite piece out of the whole bunch. The next would be these pair of jeans. No, actually, gloves, which I lost. But yeah, then these pair of jeans. That's been it. I've recorded like 4 times already because I ran out of storage a few times, but it should be alright now. I hope I'm recording. Actually, let me just check. As I said in the beginning, this was my first video I wrote a script for. I was actually loosely following it. I was thinking I'm gonna read more, but I'm just not the type of person to follow a script strictly, because I just like improvising a bit, if not a bit more. And as I'm saying it as I'm writing the script, but I'm really thankful that you watched this video. Follow me on Instagram if you want to see fit pics, fit videos, crazy things. My stories are pretty cool if you haven't seen them. You can get some inspo from them. I usually share whatever I like, and most people find it interesting and inspirational. So like the video if you liked it. It helps a lot, I think. Like, I really want to grow my channel, to be honest. Just because I feel like it will motivate me to do more and to learn more and to share more, which is always a great thing. Leave some comments, tell me which piece was your favorite. Honestly, like reading YouTube comments a lot, it's for some reason so nice when I see someone has commented. And yeah, and subscribe lastly if you enjoy the content and want to see more. That's it for me. I love you more than a stepfather loves his stepdaughter. I'll see you next time. Peace.